And Ms. Harris, good afternoon to you.
Good afternoon. Thank you, Chairwoman Davis and Representative Sheffield. My name is Aurora Harris. I'm the Southern Partnerships Manager at Young Invincibles, or YI, and we are a member of the Cover Texas Now Coalition. YI is a national nonpartisan research and advocacy organization focused on critical economic, health care, and workforce issues facing young people aged 18 to 34. Here in Texas, we're based in Houston and in Austin, and we work with college students, parents, working class young people, and those that live at the intersection of all three to lift up their health care policy concerns, and I thank you again for the opportunity to testify in front of you today. So the loss of the individual mandate last year, the current administration's intention to lengthen short-term health plans and allow the expansion of association health plans, and disinvestment in the ACA enrollment assistance and advertising has made a future higher uninsured rate of young people a predictable reality. Taken together, these actions have the potential to erode consumer protections, increase premiums, and create uncertainty about the future of the marketplaces. And we need a Texas-specific approach that maximizes the benefits of federal dollars to expand coverage in our state. And this is especially pressing to us, as 1.8 million Texas millennials are already living without health insurance. With the ACA, we saw the uninsured rate for young people decline from 29% to 16% at a national level. And so we see funding for ACA assistance programs as a critical health equity issue, as Navigator's community role gives them a unique ability to connect with clients year-round and build trust with communities that face discrimination within healthcare settings. Navigators also help families with and communities with complex needs, such as limited English proficiency, low computer and health insurance literacy, and those people who are new to the healthcare system entirely, and that's especially a lot of young people. As people have said before, the vast majority of Medicaid recipients that can work do, and so Texas should take a critical look at any congressional proposals that could further restrict access to the Medicaid program. These options, while proposed to give states more spending flexibility, will result in funding cuts, as many people have said before, putting fiscal pressure on our state to make up the difference and further threatening already vulnerable populations' access to care. 54% of Texans in the Medicaid coverage gap are millennials, and I see the impact of the gap when I speak to students like Udime at Lone Star College, who at age 26 hasn't had health insurance in 11 years. He works to support himself in school, yet he can't access an affordable health plan, and his story is not uncommon. Young, healthy adults like Udime will likely be targets for the expansion of short-term health plans that may seem low in cost, but in reality will expose him to increased financial risk and high costs if he needs to use his coverage. Texas has a number of options to step in and protect consumers, including banning short-term plans that don't comply with ACA consumer protections, restoring the three-month limit so that they are truly short-term, and increasing insurance oversight of these plans. Texas's young adults are also Texas's new parents, and our state's maternal mortality and morbidity crisis directly impacts these families. And experts in our state have identified a lack of access to high-quality preventative and early prenatal care as significant contributors to why we lead the country in the rates of mothers dying. Expanding access to coverage would improve the health and well-being of these women and their families across our state. And so lastly, I just want to say young people are striving to create better futures for themselves as students, parents, and employees, but their access to health care continues to be further out of reach. And I and my organization urge you to develop plans that will effectively use federal funds to bring the options of of affordable health coverage to more young people. And thank you for the opportunity to testify. And I read it verbatim because I wanted to stay under 3 minutes.
Well, I appreciate that, and I appreciate your testimony, and, you know, we're always excited to see millennials engaged
yes.
in the political process, so thank you for being here. Did you travel from Houston, or are you
Austin-based? I did. Houston, right. Yeah.
Well, thank you for traveling, and safe travels back home.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.